Good morning, students. Today we are going to start a new chapter, fraction, of class 7. What we are going to learn today, that is a definition of fraction, various of types of fractions with example, conversion of one form to another form of fraction, standard form of the fraction, comparison of fraction. Now, what is fraction? The number of the form a by b, where a and b are the natural numbers and b is not equals to 0, are known as fraction. This is the definition for fraction. Or we can also learn in the previous classes, a fraction is the number which represents the part of whole. Here we have to see that is a part of whole. It means fraction represents the part of any complete thing. Suppose that we are having a one complete rectangle is here, big rectangle, and this rectangle is divided into four equal parts. Then each part is expressed in the form of this one. That is, suppose that we are having a three sided part, and three sided parts are represented by a number, that is 3/4, where 3 is your numerator and 4 is your denominator. And such numbers which is in the form of p, that is a by b, is known as fraction. For example, that is, suppose that 3 upon 5 is there, then 3 upon 5 is a fraction where 3 is numerator and 5 is denominator. Simply we can say 17 upon 5 is also a fraction, which is in the form of a by b, where 17 is numerator and 5 is your denominator. Now the various types of fraction. The first we are going to take, that is a decimal fraction. So let's talk about the decimal fraction. A fraction whose denominator is any of the numbers like 10, 100, 1000, etc. are known as decimal fraction. Why these are called a decimal fraction? Because when we convert any decimal number in the form of fraction, then we have to write like a 0.3 is converted into fraction, that is 3/10. That's why these are also known as the decimal fraction. Next is your vulgar fraction, a fraction whose denominator is whole number other than 10, 100, 1000, etc. is called vulgar fraction. Or we can say that a fraction which are non-decimal fraction are said to be a vulgar fraction. Proper fraction, a proper fraction whose numerator is less than its denominator is called a proper fraction. For example, 2/3, 2/7, 5/17, all these are the proper fraction. Why? Because here in every case numerator is smaller than denominator. Now, improper fraction. Improper fraction are those fraction in which numerator is more than or equal to its denominator. For example, 6/5, here 6 is greater than 5, therefore it is said to be a improper fraction. Similarly, 19/12, 19 is greater than 12, 36/25, 36 is greater than 25. Therefore, all these are said to be an improper fraction. Other than this, all the natural numbers are also said to be an improper fraction. Why? Because 5/1, in which 5 is greater than its denominator 1, therefore it is said to be an improper fraction. Mixed fraction, a number which can be expressed as a sum of natural number and a proper fraction is called a mixed fraction. An improper fraction represented as a sum of whole and parts, that is said to be a mixed fraction. So let's see, as we already said that mixed fraction is a sum of whole number and proper fraction. So any improper fraction can be converted like a proper fraction with the help of mixed fraction. So let's see with an example. Suppose that 4 whole 1 by 5, it is a mixed fraction. Here 4 is the whole number part and 1 by 5 is the proper fraction. Similarly, 3 whole 2 by 7, 3 is the whole number part and 2 by 7 is the proper fraction. 1 by 2, again 1 plus 1 by 2, 1 is a whole number and 1 by 2 is a proper fraction. Now how we can convert a mixed fraction into improper fraction or an improper fraction into a mixed fraction. So let's see with example. 4 whole 1 by 5 can also be written as 4 plus 1 by 5. On solving, what we'll get in numerator, we have to write 4 into 5 plus 1, that is 21, and the denominator will be remain same. So your 4 whole 1 by 5 can also be written as 21 upon 5, which is an improper fraction. Now when we're talking about, that is 5 by 4, which is an improper fraction, now we have to convert it into mixed fraction. So we have to divide numerator by denominator. So here we are having a division. So that is, when you divide 5 by 4, your remainder will be 1 and quotient is also 1. So now you have to write, quotient will be written here and remainder becomes a numerator and denominator will be the same. So this is the way how we can convert any improper fraction into mixed fraction. Equivalent fraction. Equivalent fractions are also a fraction which are obtained either by multiplying or by dividing the numerator and denominator by the same non-zero number of a given fraction. So how we can get? That is by either by multiplying or by dividing the numerator and denominator of given fraction by the same non-zero number. Why they are called equivalent fraction? Because they are having equal values. Two fraction, if a fraction is there and its equivalent fraction is there, both are equal in values. That's why they are said to be an equivalent fraction. Now let's see. Suppose that 1 by 2 is your fraction. So how we can obtain that is equivalent fraction? Just by multiplying 2 in both numerator and denominator. So 1 into 2, that is equals to 2. 2 is a 4. So now 2 by 4, here we can see 2 by 4 is the equivalent fraction of 1 by 2. Similarly, when we multiply 4 in 1 by 2 in both numerator and denominator, you will get 4 by 8, which is also an equivalent fraction of 1 by 2. Unit fraction. A fraction having 1 as the numerator is called unit fraction. For example, 1 by 17, 1 by 5, 1 by 2. All these are said to be a unit fraction. Now next is your like fraction. So like fraction are those fractions whose denominators are same. It means we are talking about two or more fractions. When two or more fractions are having same denominator, numerators are different, but these are said to be a like fractions. Now unlike fraction, when you're talking about two or more fractions with different denominators, they are said to be a unlike fraction. Like 9 by 3, 2 by 7, 19 by 52, 1 by 10. All these are said to be a unlike fraction. Now, how we can convert an unlike fraction into a like fraction? So we can convert unlike fraction into a like fraction by following two steps. First, take the LCM of denominators of all the given fractions and change each of the given fraction into equivalent fractions having denominator equal to the LCM of the denominator of the given fraction. So let's see with an example. Example 1. Convert the fraction 3 by 4, 5 by 6, 1 by 12 into like fraction. So according to the method, first take the LCM of 3 denominators 4, 6 and 12. So LCM is your 12. Then change all 3 fractions to equivalent fraction with the denominator equals to 12 by multiplying a common factors. So let's say 3 by 4 is converted into equivalent fraction with denominator 12 by multiplying 3 in both numerator and denominator. Similarly, 5 by 6 is converted into 10 upon 12 by multiplying 2 in both numerator and denominator. Now all these fractions becomes equivalent fraction. All these fractions are having same denominator, so they become a like fraction. So this is the way how we can convert unlike fractions into like fraction. Now the lowest form of fraction. Lowest form of fraction, it is also said to be a simplest form or a standard form of fraction or an irreducible form of fraction. So the lowest form or a standard form or irreducible form of fraction is that form in which the LCF of numerator and denominator of given fraction is equals to 1. So standard form is what? When a fraction whose numerator and denominator are prime numbers, or we can say that is the LCF is 1, then they are said to be in lowest form. So let's see, for example, 7 upon 9 is given to you. Now we have to check whether it is in standard form or not. Since the LCF of 7 and 9 is 1, that is, since these are the co-prime numbers, therefore their LCF is 1, so they are in lowest form, or we can say that 7 upon 9 is the standard form of the fraction. Now, comparison of fraction. We can compare fraction in two ways. One by cross multiplication method, another by taking LCM and converting them into a like fraction. So, by using cross multiplication method, it is applicable only for comparing two fractions. Suppose that A by B and C by D are two given fractions. Then, just by cross multiplying them, keeping numerators at the same place and multiply the corresponding denominators in the given numerators, so you will get a product like first one. Like AD is greater than BC. If your AD is greater than BC, then we can say that A by B is greater than C by D. Similarly, if AD is smaller than BC, then A by B is smaller than C by D. And if AD is equals to BC, then we can say that A by B is equals to C by D. Let's take an example to compare two fraction by using cross multiplication method. So first one is your 3 by 5 and 5 by 8. So what we have to do first? First we have to cross multiply, that is multiply the denominator of first with the numerator of second and denominator of second with the numerator of first, keeping numerators at the same place. That is important thing, keeping numerators are of same place. Don't move the numerators, only move denominators. For example, that is 3 is multiplied with 8, which gives you 24, and 5 multiplied with the 5 gives 25. Now we have to compare, that is both the product. Since 24 is smaller than 25, so obviously that is 3 by 5 is smaller than 5 by 8. Similarly, if we take a second example, 9 by 16 and 13 by 24. So again, keeping 9 and 13 at the same place, multiply 9 with 24 and 13 with 16. Your product will be 9 into 24, that is 216, 16 into 13, that is 208, which gives you 216 greater than 208. Since 216 is greater than 208, therefore 9 by 16 is also greater than 13 by 24. Now suppose that we are having two or more than two fractions, then how we can compare it, or how we can arrange them in a increasing or decreasing order, or in ascending or descending order. So comparing and ordering of fraction. Suppose an example, we are taking 5 by 6, 2 by 9, 5 by 12, and we have to arrange them in ascending order. So all the three fractions are unlike fraction. So first find the equivalent fraction of all three fractions by finding the LCM of all the three denominators 6, 9 and 12 to make the fraction like. So first thing is to, we have to convert them into a like fraction by making denominators equals to their LCM. So first take the LCM of denominator, so LCM will be your 36. Now convert all the three into same denominator, fraction with same denominator, like 5 by 6 is converted into, that is 30 by 36, and 2 by 9 is converted into 8 by 36, 5 by 12 is converted into 15 by 36. Now compare the numerators and arrange the fraction according to the increasing or ascending order of their numerators. So ascending order means smallest one will be written first. So 8 upon 36 is the smallest number, then 15 upon 36, then 30 upon 36. So this is your required order. Now we are going to end our session. So in next class we will discuss about the addition and subtraction of fraction. Till you have to do question number 1, question number 2 and question number 3 in your homework. For any query, you can contact to us in your WhatsApp group. Be safe, stay at home. Thank you.